Good morning, guys. I was fortunate enough to be able to test a 4070 on launch day yesterday for you guys. The test setup is a regular old B250 BioStar motherboard, a G4400, 8 gigs of RAM, and a MSI Ventus 3X RTX 4070 12 gig. Showing you around where we actually are, but this is the actual card used, because this was a retail sample purchased at a micro center, and I essentially just wanted to see if this was another in the line of Ampere cards where they had a really strong core but a pretty weak memory bus, and it turned out to be not really what I expected at all. So the build quality seems great. The fan hubs are a little bit bigger than the 30 series fan hubs, so I think these will have better longevity. The MSI fans have never been terrible, like Asus, PNY, Zotac, but the card seems like it'll actually perform pretty well. The cooler is more than up to the task, even at full power. So plastic backplate, I don't like very much, but overall the card's pretty nice. Unfortunately, I had a HiveOS install on a USB drive, so it took over an hour just to get this thing ready. It's worth noting that you do need a new driver update on HiveOS for this 525.100 or something. So I started off with Caspa, and you'll see the most testing here just because I wasn't sure if we would see better efficiency at lower or higher core clocks. The Ada Lovelace GPUs are known for having a very high clock speed capability, and you can see that the efficiency really doesn't change too much until you get above 2400 megahertz. And these cards are able to really brute force a lot on core algorithms with a clock speed that high. So I found the best results on Caspa were actually at a little bit lower, so the 1530 core clock. But still, they got really good efficiency all the way up to 2410. Elysium's the same story. Not really standout, but then we get down to Dynex here. And this was almost double the hash rate at the same power as a 3070. So these cards seem like they're really good for Dynex. This was tested with SRB Miner 2.2.4. NEXA, I had two different settings here. It looks like it vastly prefers the lower core clock once you start adding memory power into the equation. FLUX, unfortunately, the card's kind of a letdown. This is almost the same efficiency as you would get from a RTX 3070, and the hash rate's actually a little bit lower at the given wattage. So that was kind of what I found with this card for the most part, except for on Dynex. You could get almost the same efficiency and raw power out of a 3070 at less than half the price. So you can see that with ETC here, the memory bus, even though it's GDDR6X, is just collapsing under the weight. So 53 mega hash, not great. So memory subsystem is still pretty weak. And the rest of this video, I'm going to just be showing you the actual video clips of me testing the cards. This is just going over the exact same data that we saw in the spreadsheet. So I would just potentially go back to the spreadsheet and pause it if you want to get a better look at what the performance was like. But if you're bored, feel free to click through the rest of these little clips. It'll show you the tests occurring live, as well as some more GPU mining B-roll porn like this with these CMP50HXs from the last group buy. But yeah, I want to shout out my friend PloxLOL. He's in, I believe, the Misfit Mining Discord, but also the Red Panda Mining Discord. He picked this up locally and he invited me over to his home to check it out. So enjoy the rest of the little clips. But yeah, unfortunately, I think the 4070 is a no buy for me until these get below probably $400. The 3070 is just a better all-rounder.